Hello friends, in this video we will learn about various problems related to Wilson's theorem, a very important concept of number theory. So first problem is prove that an integer p is greater than 1 is a prime number if and only if factorial p minus 2 is congruent to 1 modulo p. Here it is given to us p greater than 1 is a prime number. We all know that this is a Wilson's theorem. It is a statement of Wilson's theorem. If p is a prime number, factorial p minus 1 is congruent to minus 1 modulo p. If you want to learn about the proof of Wilson's theorem, you can listen to my previous video about proof of Wilson's theorem. Now here, factorial p minus 1 is break into two parts, p minus 1 into factorial p minus 2. It is break into factorial. Now multiply this p with this one and multiply minus 1 with this one. So we get these things. Okay, now you can make this vector to right hand side. It will be here, it may become subtracted from the right hand side, and since it is divisible by p, so this part will become 0 when it take modulo 5 modulo p. So we get this one statement, and cancelling out minus 1 both side, we prove the this part. A very simple question. You can prove similarly its reverse part also. Another question, very important example. Show that factorial 18 is minus congruent to minus 1 modulo 437. In this type of the problem, you have to split this number into prime numbers. We know that factors of 437 is 19 into 23. So where here we have two prime numbers, 19 and 23. We will apply Wilson's theorem for these two prime numbers. What is the Wilson's theorem? Factorial p minus 1 congruent to minus 1 modulo p. So if we take p 19, so we write in here p 19. If we take 23 as a prime number, so we again written Wilson's theorem for p is equal to 23. On subtracting or simplifying, we get these two statements. 18 factorial is congruent to minus 1 modulo 19. This statement is okay. Another is the factorial 22 is congruent to minus 1 modulo 23. I have to modify this statement. So how will modify? I will break 22 factorial into this one, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18 factorial, so on. Now divide the all numbers on the left hand side with the 23 and writing the remainders. When we divide 22, it gives remainder minus 1. It will give remainder minus 2. 20 will give remainder minus 3. And 19 will give remainder minus 4. On division with the 24 using the modulo concept. So, their product will be 24. If we multiply these, it is a 24. I can break 24 like 23 plus 1. So multiplying these expression, this will becomes, so this part become 0 vanishes when we take modulo 23. So we get 18 factorial is congruent to minus 1 modulo 23. Okay, since GCD of 19 and 23 is 1, so using equation number 1 and equation number 3, we get factorial 18 is congruent to minus 1 modulo 19 into 23. So their product is 437. Hence the proved. This question is proved here. A very easy question. First of all, you have to make the factors of this and apply Wilson's theorem for the both prime numbers and simplify the problem. Next one, show that factorial p minus 1 is congruent to p minus 1 modulo this one. So we know that this is a Wilson's theorem. Everyone, if we add minus 1 into p, so this is also modulo p. Of course, when we divide this with the p, we get remainder minus 1. Now, splitting the left hand side into these two parts, factorization, making the factors break. Now, cancelling p minus 1 from both sides, we get this statement. Now, this p, now using the definition of congruence, a congruent b modulo p, p will divide the difference of these two numbers. So I have written here like this. If p divide difference of these two numbers, p also divide multiple of 2 of these numbers. Multiplying both sides with the p minus 1 and dividing this 2 on the this one, left hand side. So we will get this expression. Now we know that product of two numbers is always an even number, consecutive number. So this is an even number. When we divide an even number with a 2, it is also an even number. It is an integer. So left hand side is your integer. Now we will multiply this p minus 1 with this one and this p1 minus 1 with minus 1. So it is break into two parts. So this can be written as a p minus 1 factorial. Okay. Now this is the difference of two numbers a minus b. So we can write divided by this one. So we can write that a, this is a, this is b. A is congruent to b modulo p by using the definition of congruency. If p divides a minus b, then we can write a is congruent to b modulo p. So this part is okay. Now this expression can be written like this because it is a general sequence and we know that sum of this sequence is p over p minus 1 by 2. It is a very easy question again. Another question, very important examination point of view. We have to prove this statement 1 square, 3 square, 5 square, p minus 2 square if to using the Wilson's theorem. We all know the statement of Wilson's theorem. Factorize the factorial p minus 1, p minus 1, p minus 2, p minus 3 up to 1. Now carefully listen, we have to rearrange the terms and making their pairs, like p minus 1 is arranged with the 1, p minus 3 is arranged with the 3, odd numbers are arranged first and even numbers are arranged at the last. Okay, now we are using the concept this one. We know that any number of type p minus l is congruent to minus l mod p because their difference will be much divided by p. So p minus 1 is replaced with the minus 1, p minus 3 is replaced with the minus 3, p minus 5 is replaced with the minus 5. These are used using this one. Okay. Now last there are even numbers 2, 4. Now we will use this state. Now this statement is also true for modulo p. When we difference of these, take difference of these two numbers, so we will get only p and p is divisible by p. So we can write 2 as a minus p minus 2 like this using this one. Okay, similarly we have applied for 4. Okay, in this way we have rearranged the terms, we have rearranged the terms and making their congruences using these two equations. So here we have p minus 1 terms, out of which half terms are minus 1. So collecting the these minus 1, we will get this one, and we are pairing the other terms like 1 in 1 square, 3 square, 5 square, and last one is p square, p minus 2 square, p minus 4 square, and right hand side is same here. Okay, now multiplying with minus 1 raised to power p minus 1 by 2 on both sides. So here square exists, so this square will become minus 1 raised to power p minus 1, and p is a prime number. When we subtract 1 from the prime number, it becomes an even number. So it is a 1. So this is 1 here. Okay, so this part remains left hand side, and adding the both the power of minus 1, we will get this one. On adding the power of minus 1 from here, we get this one. In this way, we have proved this question. What we have done, we have taken the Wilson's theorem and open the factorial p minus 1 and rearranging the terms and using these two congruencies, we have proved this part. Another question. In this question, we will show that 19 is a prime number using inverse of Wilson's theorem. First of all, we can break 19 minus 3 upon two pairs. In this type of questions, always subtract a prime number from 3, divide by 2. It is a 16 minus upon 2, so we have to make 8 pairs here. We will make, this is 8, so we will make 8 pairs of these prime numbers, leaving the first one and leaving the p minus 1 term. P minus 1 is 18. So leaving 1 and 18, as discussed in the proof of the Wilson's theorem, as discussed in my previous lecture, so leaving the first one and p minus 1 is 18. Leaving the 1 and 18, rearranging the other 16 numbers into 8 pairs like this. As we know that 2 into 10 is 20, it will give modulo 1. But when divided by 19, 3 into 13 is a 39. When divided by 19, it will give a remainder 1. 4 into 5, 20, it will give a remainder 1. Similarly, we have to arrange all the numbers so that they are all congruent to 1 modulo 19. On multiplying these all, we get this thing. What is this left hand side? This is, if you see clearly, and rearranging the terms in the increasing order, you will get 17 factorial 1 modulo 19. On multiplying both sides with 18, we get 18 factorial. And 18 when divided by 19, you can write is it minus 1 modulo 19. So here p is 19 and it is a p minus 1. So this theorem is proved. What is this? This is a Wilson's theorem. So using the Wilson's theorem, we can, by using the converse of Wilson's theorem, we can say that p is equal to 19 is a prime number, because we have proved this one. And what is this? This is a Wilson's theorem, and converse of Wilson's theorem say that it is a prime number. So in this video, we have learned various examples related to Wilson's theorem. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.